Hi, this is Tom Inge. I'm a professor of surgery and pediatrics at the University of Colorado Denver and Children's Hospital Colorado. I direct the Bariatric Surgery Center at Children's Hospital Colorado, and I'm here today to talk to you about a recent study that's been published with some exciting results. Just in the way of background, severe obesity affects millions of adolescents today, and lifestyle modifications, including dietary interventions, as well as physical activity, have very limited effectiveness for controlling ongoing weight gain. What we've found is that even pharmacologic or drug interventions have limited effectiveness too. Increasingly, we are realizing that weight loss surgery should be considered a treatment option for those adolescents who have become severely obese, and particularly for those who have developed a health problem or even quality of life impairment due to the extra weight. So the study I'd like to talk to you about is the comparative effectiveness of bariatric procedures among adolescents, the PCORnet Bariatric Study. With 544 patients analyzed, this study is the largest study to date which provides adolescent weight loss surgery outcome data. In this study, we also look for the first time at modern trends for use of specific procedures in adolescents undergoing bariatric surgery. In this work, we estimate the long-term weight loss outcome for three specific procedures at 1, 3, and 5 years. The results of the study are shown here. As you can see, there has been a major shift in the dominant procedure type over time, with the largest change being increased use of sleeve gastrectomy. The use of sleeve gastrectomy increased from approximately 13% of cases to 83% of cases over the course of 10 years, from 2005 to 2015. At the same time, we saw a decline in the use of Roux-en-Y gastric bypass, declining from about 50% of cases to 25% of cases over the same time period. There has been a marked decline in the use of adjustable gastric banding over the same period of time, with extremely few cases being done now. The sleeve gastrectomy is a procedure that actually removes about 80% of the stomach. So under general anesthesia, the anesthesiologist will insert a large tube into the patient's mouth and pass this tube down the esophagus and into the stomach. The surgeon will then use this as a guide to remove the portion of stomach to the right of the tube. With this operation, about 80% of the stomach is removed. This results in a very narrow and small new stomach, which means that only very small meals can be eaten. Before gastric surgery, a patient could have had 4 to 6 cups of food, whereas after a sleeve gastrectomy, a much smaller stomach can only hold about a half a cup of food during the meal. But even more importantly, the surgeon has also removed that portion of the stomach that talks to the hunger centers in the brain. And another result of this operation, then, is that appetite is dramatically reduced. This next graphic gives us the major message of the study. This shows body mass index change over time. And for the adjustable gastric band, about 10% weight loss can be seen. But the sleeve and bypass provide the most impressive findings. We see an average weight loss of about 30%. For the sleeve gastrectomy as well as the gastric bypass. The weight loss is gradual over the first 18 months, and then weight loss is largely maintained. That means that most of the individuals who had sleeve gastrectomy or gastric bypass experienced about 25 to 30% weight loss and maintained that weight loss out to 5 years. In addition to weight loss and procedure preference, the study also looked at 30-day postoperative complications. Importantly, there were no deaths reported within 30 days. And as you can see in the table, only 3% of the patients required reoperative procedures or subsequent endoscopy or percutaneous interventions. We also found the very low incidence, about 4% of blood clots forming or something called venous thromboembolism. In fact, any adverse event within 30 days, including things like urinary tract infection, pneumonia, or even a delay in discharge, happened at only about 5% of the time. So overall, looking at 30-day complications, there were very few patients that had complications, and those complications were very similar to that which had been documented and widely reported from adult series. So in conclusion, from this PCORnet study, we can say that sleeve gastrectomy has certainly become the dominant operation performed for adolescents with severe obesity. We can also say that this is the largest study to date, with 544 participants and a very long follow-up of 5 years. Adolescents undergoing gastric bypass and sleeve gastrectomy experienced excellent weight loss and maintained this weight loss over a 3 to 5 year follow-up period, while patients who had adjustable gastric banding lost the least amount of weight over the same period of time. Surgical and medical complications were infrequently observed within the perioperative period of 30 days. This has been Dr. Tom Inge at Children's Hospital Colorado. For more information, give us a call or visit the link on the screen.